Okay, hi everyone. So today I'm going to demonstrate to you about prepopulate response. Alright, so this prepopulate response is only for free response question. Alright, so I'm sure as you've been making your free response question, you probably have noticed another additional text box titled prepopulate, and you must be wondering what that is about. So prepopulate response is basically template given by the teacher. Alright, for students to continue their answer from it. Okay, so this template given by the teacher can be in the form of a table, a sentence frame, or image, as you can see here. Alright, so how it works is that the question should be at the top, and this will be for the students. So usually for me, I give the instructions for them, okay, because if not, they're quite clueless. They may think, this is the teacher's answer itself. Where do I need to type? So I always give instructions such as click on the table, okay, or double click, double tap on the image, so they know what they need to do. So when they click on the table, they can now continue and typing on their responses. Okay, so they will type all this and then they click submit. Okay, so since these are standalone questions, teachers will not be able to give comment. All right, so I provided the suggested answer for immediate feedback for the students. Okay. So here, they can also tap on it and then they can continue typing their answers. So this is good for you to guide or scaffold it for the weaker students, so they remember what the sentence frame that they need. Right? So what happens is that if you don't put in your suggested answer, okay, this is how it appears for the student, then they do not know whether the answer is right or wrong. So if your questions are standalone, do make sure that you do include your suggested answer. If you want to give feedback, then the free response question must be as a quiz format. Alright, so here we have is as an image. So when the students double click on it, okay, or double tap, because some are using iPad, they can choose whatever color they want, okay, and then they can annotate on it. Okay, they can also erase if they have made a mistake. Okay, and then they can also choose the thicker one, the highlighter mode. Okay, so there's no downloading needed on the student's end. All right, and they don't need to upload this final answer either. They just need to click save. So it appears that. And after they click submit, this is what teachers will get to view on their end. No downloading or uploading needed on the teacher's end. All right, to mark or view students' response. So likewise over here, when you double click on the image, they can write the character on it. Okay, and then when they submit, that's what the teacher will view. Okay, so it can be also used for English. So for example here, a simple matching. They can say, is that a, okay, that's a hippo, sorry, that was an elephant. Then you have the rabbit. Okay, so you can just keep continue. They can even change color if they want to. Alright, then when you click save and submit, this is what the teacher will view. Okay, and it can also be done for science. Okay, a question I've done before, arrow to represent the heat gain. Okay, so how do we do such a question? Alright, so here I have the activity. Okay, so it may look plain without all the images. Okay, but when you click edit, you can see that it's under this prepopulate student response. Okay, so let's start from scratch. How to go about from here? Choose free response, click on create new. Okay, so here I just give a basic question. Okay, maybe I want them to label the parts of the flower. Okay, then under this prepopulate student's response, you can add the image using here, add media. So I have the image here on PowerPoint. As you can see, this is an image, but these are text box. So here is another tips. When you select all, you can right click and save as picture. Okay, then after that, you can now save as PNG or JPEG. Either format is fine. Okay, so any of the format is fine. Now going back to here, add media, upload, choose a file. Now I can choose the earlier file. Okay, so this is what will appear for the students, and they can simply annotate to match the parts of the flower. Okay, so usually I will also add instruction for the students, as I said earlier. Okay, double click, double tap on image. So I always add this part, if not they're quite confused like what to do about it. So if you have the suggested answer, you can input it in here as well. Okay, then how about if there's a table? Okay, so for a table, we add free response, create new. So use the table below. Alright, so here under Prepopulate, I will choose the table. Okay. So depends on what you want. Now, to make sure you have the border for it, choose table property, choose solid. Okay. Then usually I just choose black. Right, then you have it. So then you can input all the things in the table. So then this is what the students get to do, and they can fill up this part. You can also do other aesthetic parts such as to bold them, to make it centralized, stuff like that. Okay, so this is how you can do free response questions with Prepopulate response. It's basically a template for the students to work on. Okay, that is all then for my sharing today. Thank you.